The February Finance Committee meeting, roll call.
Councilman Kraus.
Here.
Councilwoman Meany.
Here.
Councilman Pedicino.
Here.
All right, we've got first our regular minutes from January 20th.
Motion.
I'll make a motion to approve the minutes of January 20th, 2016.
Second.
Motion second. Any discussion? Roll call.
Councilman Kraus.
Yes.
Councilwoman Meany.
Yes.
Councilman Pedicino.
Yes.
All right, then we have our special meeting February 1st.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion second. Any discussion? Roll call.
Councilman Kraus.
Yes.
Councilwoman Meany.
Yes.
Councilman Pedicino.
Yes.
Okay, first off, number one, we have Home Days ride agreement for 2016, which is attached with the City of Solon and Great Lakes Expositions. Rich?
Yes, the Recreation Department is requesting legislation to enter into a contract with Great Lakes Expositions, which is the ride company that we have used for many years for Solon Home Days. And then also to is requesting authorization for a purchase order in the amount of $52,500, which is the estimated revenue that would be due to Great Lakes for ticket sales.
Yeah, questions?
Nope. I mean, I guess I did too. Didn't we used to get more money? Wasn't it more of a like a 50-50 split? Or, I'm sorry, am I?
No,
done
the
this so many times that I just.
The standard has been 25% to 30%.
Okay. Okay. I know we did real well last year.
Last year was a great year, and I've actually estimated doing a little better this year.
We like that. Okay. Well, I will go ahead then and make the motion to prepare legislation to issue a purchase order in the amount of $52,500 for the Home Days ride agreement with Great Lakes. You don't need this under emergency, do you?
Second.
All right, a motion and a second. Yeah, because this will get, we'll have it in plenty of time, even if we give it three readings. Okay. A motion and a second. Any discussion? Roll call.
Councilman Kraus.
Yes.
Councilwoman Meany.
Yes.
Councilman Pedicino.
Yes.
Okay, thank you, gentlemen. Item two is a memo from Jill Frankel regarding the Ohio Arts Council Creative Aging Ohio Initiative Award. And thanks, Jill, for providing all the various background information regarding the Arts Council and the award process. And it looks like the request is to accept the $14,988 grant award from the council. Jill?
Good evening. Yes, I'm requesting approval to accept a $14,988 grant award from the Ohio Arts Council to provide programming and participate in the Creative Aging Ohio Initiative. The award will cover the expenses required to integrate the digital mosaic into our programming, and this will allow us to provide formal oral storytelling program, expand our reminiscence programming, as well as utilize video as a performance arts instructional tool. In addition to the benefits received through arts participation, the seniors will have the ability to leave a legacy by privately sharing their videos and experiences with their loved ones. I am asking that it be passed under an emergency because the award announcement was received extremely close to the award period, mm-hmm. and the award period is very short.
Any questions?
I have a comment. I think this
sure.
is really cool.
Yeah.
I mean, I just really think what a neat thing, and I sure wish, I had my grandparents do something like this, and I just think, it's really a great thing. And I guess my only other question, Jill, with this contract, I assume you had our law director check this over, and he said
correct.
Everything was okay. Okay, no, I think this is wonderful. And thank you for getting this grant for us.
Well, thank
for
you.
Our seniors.
Okay. Motion to prepare legislation to accept a $5,000 grant award from the Ohio Arts Council in order to provide programming to participate in the Creative Aging Ohio Initiative and declaring an emergency.
Second.
Okay, motion to second. Any further discussion? Roll call.
Councilman Kraus?
Yes.
Councilwoman Meany?
Yes.
Councilman Pedicino?
Yes.
Thank you, Jill.
Thank you.
All right. Item three is a memo from Christina regarding the safety and service levy renewal. I know we had just preliminary discussions, was it last week, at our budget, and we thought it would be a good opportunity while we have the time to have that discussion before we'd have to put it on the ballot for this year. So we have some background and the prior legislation. Christina?
Good evening. As Councilman Kraus said, this was something that we discussed at the budget hearings, but to give everyone a little bit of background, this was something that was approved by voters in 1986, and what it does is provides capital funding to the police, fire, and service departments for any equipment needs that they may have that come up. It's renewed on a five-year cycle, and every 5 years it's put to the electorate to renew. It needs to go on the ballot for them to renew the tax levy. It produces about $500,000 in revenue every year, and because the tax levy is outside of the allowed 10 mils per the Ohio Revised Code, it needs to be put to the voters if they want to renew it or not. As part of this request, there's two pieces of legislation that are needed. The first one would be the ordinance declaring it necessary to renew the level and to request the Cuyahoga County Auditor to certify our current tax valuation for the city. And that will give us the dollar amount of revenue that the levy will actually produce. And the second piece of legislation is the ordinance requiring submittal to the electors of the city to question, with the question of renewing the 0.5 mil tax levy for the Safety Forces and Service Department. And I'm requesting that both pieces of those legislation be passed under emergency so I can start working with the Clerk of Council's office to get everything ready to be submitted to the Board of Elections.
Yeah, go ahead.
Christina, there shouldn't be any issues with the county. I mean, what's the process that the county does as far as...
I believe the last time we did it, we actually did have assistance from Squire Sanders, who is normally our bond counsel. They work with Cuyahoga County just figuring out what the total property valuation is for the city, and then they figure out, you know, what each property is going to be assessed for the levy.
Okay, but the renewal itself would just be basically the same dollar figure that we have in the past?
Yes.
Okay.
So the last time was in 11?
Yes.
So it's obviously it's time.
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
Okay. First,
I can do them. Yeah. Okay, I'll make a motion to have legislation prepared requesting an ordinance. Wait a minute. Yeah, an ordinance declaring it necessary to renew the levy and requesting the Cuyahoga County Auditor to certify the current tax valuation of the city and the dollar amount of revenue that would be generated by the levy under emergency.
Second.
All right. Motion and a second. Discussion. Roll call.
Councilman Kraus?
Yes.
Councilwoman Meany?
Yes.
Councilman Pedicino?
Yes.
All right.
And then the... I would make a motion to have legislation prepared requiring an ordinance submitting to the electors of the city of Solon the question of renewing the 0.5 mil tax levy for the Safety Forces and Service Department and declaring an emergency.
Second.
Motion a second. Any further discussion? Roll call.
Councilman Kraus?
Yes.
Councilwoman Meany?
Yes.
Councilman Pedicino?
Yes.
Okay, and number four, lastly on our agenda, is a memo from Don Holub regarding the equipment athletic wear bids for the Recreation Department, Service Department, Grantwood, and the Center for the Arts. Don, welcome.
You should have before you a memo and also the breakdown of all the bidders and the prices that they bid. This one is a little bit different in that we accept each item on its own merit. In other words, you may receive just one item. You could receive all the items if you had the lowest bid. This actually allows us to get the cheapest price. One note on this one is we did have one company that did note that their pricing is only good if all of their bid items were accepted, and they were not the lowest on all of them. So it actually took any of theirs out of play. So kind of unfortunate because they were low bid on a couple, but we did accept all the low bids on each item. And we're just asking that this is passed under emergency only because we want to get these, some of these are for our spring and summer programs, and we want to get the lowest price possible. I just would note that also we now have Recreation, Grantwood, the Service Department, and the Center of the Arts all use this, so we're trying to do as much as we can under this.
Is that new this year?
The Service Department we added last year, and Center of the Arts, I think this is the second year for them also.
I have a couple questions.
Go ahead, Nancy.
I mean, on some of these, Don, I see like when you got no bids on some, like the baseball, softball hats. No bids from anybody. And I noticed right. a number of, you know, going back when you get into the swimming stuff, that what do you do when you have no bids?
We would still, we may not go out to bid on those individual items, but we would still go and get quotes for them.
Okay.
I will note, I think on the baseball hats, mm-hmm. We didn't get them on the major league. We did get them on the minor league. We'll probably just use the minor league hats then, okay. in that instance.
Okay. And then you were talking about low bids, and where was it? I knew I should have marked these. Got too many pages here, Don.
I know.
Okay. Oh, here we go. The Rawlings shin guards. You're going with Pyramid School.
I should have noted that if it was a substitute bid, you know, we'll look at the substitute.
What does that mean? You have sub 15 sub.
It just means that we actually are bidding one item. It could be their. Sometimes it's their equivalent, or if they don't have that, they'll bid another item. Is what happens
I see.
There.
Okay.
So what we do is we look at the item in their catalogs, or they'll send us a sample, and if we like it, we will accept okay. it. If we don't, we don't accept
okay.
it.
So basically that means that they didn't actually have these Rawlings shin guards in that model number, but here is one that's
right.
similar.
Sometimes okay. it's just as good. Sometimes it's a cheaper item.
Okay.
So.
Like the soccer balls?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I know you've used sub before. I couldn't quite remember. I figured
yeah.
it was this kind of a substitute, not exactly what you're asking for. Okay. Well, you had a lot more to do now that you've added these different departments, but I think it's good, you know, if we might as well just do them, like especially like T-shirts for the Center for the Arts, and
absolutely.
I think it certainly makes sense.
You know, they're either going out and getting quotes or bids anyway, so to do
right.
it all at once,
well,
it makes
well
it a lot.
Do it all.
Yeah.
Do you get a better deal, Don, with
the more? Well, you know what happens is the more. Yes, we do. I will tell you that on these T-shirts, before we bid, we were probably paying. I'm not going to say double, but close to double on a lot of those. And when you start bidding, they knock it down to their best price because
sure,
you know, some companies just want to get in here and get our business. So
yeah, okay, good, great.
Okay, I make a motion to approve legislation accepting the lowest bid tabulations in the document that's provided. In order to purchase respective equipment and declaring an emergency.
Second.
Motion and second. Any discussion? Roll call.
Councilman Kraus?
Yes.
Councilwoman Meany?
Yes.
Councilman Pedicino?
Yes.
Okay. Brings us to the end of our agenda. Any further business?
Did we need to go over this or not? Christina, did you want to go over this memorandum that we got last night at our council meeting or...
I don't have it with me, but I can,
okay.
it was, I know Councilman Palunas had asked for just a brief listing of any of the changes that were made throughout the budget. I know that we made the changes for the transfers, so that it would show on the revenue and the expense side. One of the changes to revenue was the ambulance billing, because we had just recently changed the fees, so we increased their estimated revenue. And I believe those were the only changes that I can recall off the top of my head.
Yeah, just mostly talks about the transfers, $3.6 million to Fund 435, and that's for the roof replacement at City Hall and the Police Department. Transfer $750,000 to 491. That's just for capital improvements throughout the city. And then just the transfer line was changed to reflect a $3.6 million transfer. And transfer line, the $750,000 transfer to 491.
So there weren't too many changes, but the transfer ones were the most significant, because
right,
they affect
sure.
both revenue yeah. and expenses.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, anything further?
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Motion and second. Any discussion? Roll call.
Councilman Krause?
Yes.
Councilwoman Meany?
Yes.
Councilman Pedicino?
Yes. Time's your game, Eddie.